Put your hands together for the best drummer on this side. For the man of God. That brother is on fire. Amen, amen. But this evening I welcome you to this, our second night of this great, great convention, our 37th annual convention under the theme Prayer That Makes the Church Bold. Amen. Any prayer warriors in this place? Any bold prayer warriors in this place? Hallelujah. I told the congregation on Sunday that prayer should not be an obligation, but prayer should be a privilege. Amen? It's a privilege to go into the presence of the Almighty God, because prayer brings heaven down to earth. Amen? Hallelujah. And do you know that prayer is an opposing force? Jesus. James had lost his life. But when the church prayed, Peter, that was in prison. Hallelujah. The angels came, opened the prison door, the shackles fell off.
Apostle Christopher Russell from BAI,
Bishop Rudolph and Pastor Linda Balfour from New Wine Kingdom Ministry. Bishop Goliath Burroughs from the senior pastor of the Southland Church of God. Overseer Julian Monroe and Lady Monroe. They're here with us from Bible Life Ministries. Representing Bishop Anthony Johnson is Minister Lorenzo Bain from the Porter's House Ministry. Good to have my long, long time friend evangelist Clifton Stowell from Calvary Temple, the old church. He was here last night, he's here again tonight with his wife Bishop John and Ella Lucy May Wright from the Community Holiness. Hallelujah. Good to have Sister Nicola Russell. Hallelujah. Somebody in this area. Oh, I can't forget the preacher. Bishop Barrington. Smith, all the way from Canada. Amen. 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 Now, I've been married long enough to know when my wife's saying something, you better listen.
Can I show you saying something? I can't hear you.
Sister Deborah Evans, that's my mother. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Good to have all of you here in this place tonight. And we are really happy to have the Church of God of Prophecy. And Brother Morris Chapel visiting with us tonight, and it's good to have the best photographer in the city, Brother Michael Scott. Hallelujah. Brother Mike, you have your book with you tonight? Okay, I'll give you a moment very shortly to talk about the Holy Rollers, Holy Jumpers. Wow, listen, thanks so much of Holy Jumpers, Holy Rollers, Pentecost. Amen. 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 But tonight, we are happy to have all of you. Come on, put your hands together. Amen. We're going to have the, in this order, Apostle Christopher Russell, the prelay of the BAIC churches. They're here with us tonight, a group that I love to fellowship with. And also, we're going to have the senior pastor of Southland, Bishop Goliath Burroughs, to bring greetings to us tonight. And then we're going to ask our very own Brother Lorenzo Bain from Porter's House to represent his bishop on tonight. We're going to ask him to bring greetings. And finally, I will ask the preacher on last night just to say hello to us. Amen? Yeah. Amen, Dr. Sharon Rowe. Yeah. That order.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
It is indeed an honor and a blessing for us to be here tonight, to be BAIC, of which I'm the prelude of that organization, and Bishop being a part of that. We decided to come down tonight so we could fellowship, celebrate, and then also to be a blessing. 37 years is a while, and God has really been good, and Calvary Deliverance, you deserve all rights to celebrate, to make as much noise as you want. This is your party. So again, congratulations to Bishop Newry, Sister Queenie Newry, and the fine membership. It's beautiful and awesome church. The Lord bless you.
Good evening, family.
Good evening.
It's always good to be home. Yeah. For those of you who are new, I'm Ray, and I'm visiting from the Porter's House representing the pastor. He is on a much needed vacation for his wife and his family. And it is always a pleasure to be in Calvary Deliverance, and I can attest to how far God has brought this church from, because I spent 14 years of my life here. Also, the former pastors of this church, every time I come here, I feel like home. So I'm not speaking to any one of you, just the new members that might be here. But to God be the glory, may the Lord bless each and every one of y'all as God continue to take y'all from strength to strength. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
It is indeed a pleasure for me to be here this evening to celebrate with you on this 37th year of ministry here on East Street. I just want to congratulate your senior pastor, Bishop Newry. Matter of fact, we share something in common.
Yeah.
I think we were installed the same year
in
the position of senior pastor of respective ministries. I just want to encourage you to go forward. And go forward with a faith like steel. Because prayer without faith is dead. Everyone, Jesus said, who asks, receives. But you have to believe or ask without doubt. You have to be like Daniel and the Hebrew boys. It didn't matter what the enemy come against you with. It didn't matter how severe the offense was against you. Their confidence was in God. Amen. He said he could destroy this body, but we are confident that if God wants to deliver, we shall be. So I'll go forward in this year, believing that God is going to answer everyone who asks. Amen.
Amen.
If you ask, you shall receive. God bless you and have a wonderful day.
But I can say tonight, in short,
Because of prayer, we all are here tonight.
Amen.
Does someone show amen?
Amen.
37 years is a long time, but just like what I just said, God is able to do all things. And I will say this to you, Bishop, and I'm going to take my seat, to Bishop Newry, because of prayer, he is here tonight. So can I hear some noise? Can I hear some noise? I said, because of prayer, Bishop Newry is here. And I'll say this as I take my seat. Because of prayer, your answer is at your door.
Hallelujah, we do thank all of our fine ministers who blessed us in appreciation for what God has done. Amen. It's offering time in this house. No schemes, no gimmicks. Simply offering time. A feast is made for laughter. Wine make it merry, but money answers for all things. 37 years, God has blessed us, and we have been a tremendous blessing to this community and to our Bahama land. And so as we celebrate tonight, I want you to bless me or bless this ministry in a very special way. Members of our church, you know what your convention pledges are. And you find wonderful people. I know that you bought a gift here tonight. You didn't come empty-handed, you bought gifts. Amen. Amen, amen. And so I'm going to ask all of our ministers, if you can, if you can give me $200, I would appreciate that. Amen. I can leave $100 for the floor. Except for the exception of Brother John, right? Because he can do more than that. Boy, listen, man, it's good that you can have friends, you can call their names, and they ain't get mine. You know, some Christians, you call their names, and they mine. That if you come together, they can call your name. Right? You can get mad at me on the outside and be sitting in here. You gotta be at peace. Amen? Amen. But we are indeed happy to have all of you. Now I'm gonna get this offering started. The 200, and so I'm looking for some ministers and even some floor members. You can join me. Alright, amen. I've got 5 minutes. 5 minutes to raise this offering. Amen. And I got a budget. Gotta meet my budget, right? And I need you to help me meet that, because at the end of the night, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. That's what I'm talking about. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Hallelujah. Music, God, you can give me some music. Thank you. Thank you. My tool, you know. I gotta set the page, right? You can't be telling y'all to give when I'm not giving. Thank you. Thank you, Bishop. Thank you, Brother John, Elder John, right? So he needs some more $200. Nothing wrong with that, right? Passes, no. When we have celebration, it comes with a cost. Amen. Hallelujah. He's been good. Don't stare me down because you don't move me. I've been around church too long. Amen. Amen. I can tell you, God is a good God. He'll give you houses you didn't build. Then you are obedient to His word. You'll cause cancer to disappear from your body. Amen. You'll cause your heart attack to go away. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's Pastor Brown. The Lord bless you, Pastor.
your time. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Can I have some more? At least two more. Amen. Hallelujah. I've learned something from my friend, Mr. Balfour, with the pew. Everybody get together in the pew then. See if you can get $200 from me. Amen. Please don't send me no email. Don't write me on WhatsApp. This is for the house of the Lord. Amen. And those of us who've been around church for any length of time, you know, after July, everybody go on vacation in August and September. The Lord bless you. So while we have this wonderful opportunity, I want you to be a blessing. Amen. Okay? Can somebody bless me with $100? I have a number of persons, at least 10. $100. $100. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you. Come on, give this business woman a hand.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. You get the most tastiest wings in the city. Right down the street. I know you do. Because I got a condition. Hallelujah. Thank you. I'm trying to stay off that fry stuff. Hallelujah. For some of you, yeah. Amen. $100. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I know you bought something. You didn't tell me you're empty handed. You bought something tonight. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 It's Pastor Brown.
Yes.
The Lord bless you, sir. Thank you, Lord. 200. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Do you have some $100 bills? $100 bills? Now, ushers know that I normally don't do this, but since we're in convention, I can take the time tonight. You know, convention calls for celebration. It also calls for us to bring a wonderful offering. Amen. When you think back on 37 years ago, when we started out in E.B. Roberts or the school, you think we built this building to crumble up just all the bills? Came with some money to cut up. Right? For many of us, we decided to let the father of the nation rest in peace.
Yeah.
It's like, you know, when you go into the store and you want to buy something nice, it costs you. Right? It costs you. So, some of you spent some good money elsewhere. $50? $50? Everybody should be running with $50. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, my friend and brother. Thank you. $50? $50?
On-road student, thank you.
St. John's.
Thank you.
I appreciate you. Thank you. I'll walk it.
While I'm here, anybody else?
Bow your head to me. Father of God, we bless you, we honor you, we thank you for this wonderful occasion. Give our people continuous faith, that they may know that the money will leave their hands but never leave their lives. Like Moses, they will flow down on the stream and come back and be a blessing. Cause them to know God, that the more that they give, the more you will give even unto them. Let them continuously give cheerfully. I rebuke the spirit of fear, doubt, and timidity. Cause the spirit of faith. to come upon them, that they may know that you will do exceedingly abundantly above all they could ever think or imagine, according to the power that worketh in them. Bless every giver this evening. May they see increased uncommon favor, miracles taking place in their lives because of their obedience to your word. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. Just before we have our mind ministry, I'm going to invite Brother Mike to come. Ushers, you can serve. He's going to talk about his book. Mother Clementina Stubbs, our former founding pastor, she is a part of this book. Her dad is also a part of this book. He's from Cat Island. So was from Cat Island, the part of the Church of God prophecy.
Evening, church. Amen. It's a pleasure to be here this evening, and I bring greetings to Bishop Newry and all the fine members here at the Calvary Deliverance Church, all the visiting ministers, and all visiting friends. Good to see all of you. And it's good to be in the house of the Lord. Good to be in the service one more time. Are you happy to be in the service? Hallelujah. Amen. So I'm here just for a brief moment. Thank you, Pastor Newry, for this opportunity to promote my book. It's called The Holy Jumpers. And you know, one time ago, jumper was a derogatory word. But now everybody's jumping. And so we're happy to present this book. It's called The Holy Jumpers. It's, I said concise here, but it's really a comprehensive history of the Church of God, the prophecy from 1909 through 1974. Now, of course, you know, it started with the Church of God. And there was a split in 1925, and that's when prophecy really started. So it goes all the way back to the beginning. And so this book is essentially the beginning of Pentecostalism in the Bahamas. So every church that's Pentecostal, a shout, a carry on, speaking in tongues, you're a part of this. This is the root of Pentecostalism in the Bahamas. It goes all the way back to a missionary called Edmund Barr and Rebecca Barr, who were the first who came in 1909 to spread the gospel here, and the spirit of talking about the Holy Ghost and all that, and that's where it started in the Bahamas. So if you need a copy, please see me. I have a few here tonight. If not, you can just give me a name and I can bring it to you, to your business or to your home. The hardback, actually this book is 38 chapters and 730 pages. It's filled with stuff, it's not junk. This book cost me a lot. When I say cost me, in terms of, I spent 14 years researching, making trips all the way to Kid Cleveland, Tennessee. I made 20 trips over the past 14 years to Cleveland, Tennessee, all the major cities in Florida, all the university libraries in Florida, doing research to present this book. So it's well researched, it's well documented, it could stand up anywhere, at any university, it can be taught anywhere. And so I give God the glory for giving me this opportunity to do this work. And so thank you for your support in advance. And the cost for the hardback is $100. It's really worth a lot more than that. And the softback's $80. So if you want to come see me tonight, or anytime, or you just talk to me after service, and I can give your name, and I can make sure I get bring a copy to you. God bless you. Thank you for your support.
Coming now, we will invite our mind ministry. Following the mind ministry, we'll have the introduction of the speaker for this evening by Suffragan Bishop Dr. Anthony Farrington. Follow his introduction of the speaker. We will have a selection by Shabbat, and then we kindly ask you to stand after Shabbat to receive our speaker, Dr. Barrington Smith.
Thank you. Because of you, my family, our God, I can sing to you. Glory to God. Glory to God.
Anybody feel like having church tonight?
And now we read of the healing of a devil-possessed boy. And I want everyone to read with me from verse 14. And when they were come to the multitude, there came to him a certain man, kneeling down to him and saying, Lord, have mercy on my son, for he is lunatic and sore vexed. For oftentimes he falleth into the fire, and oft into the water. And I brought him to thy disciples, and they could not cure him. Mighty God. Then Jesus answered and said, O faithless and perverse generation, how long shall I be with you? How long shall I suffer you? Bring him hither to me. And Jesus rebuked the devil, and he departed out of him, and the child was cured that very hour. Then came the disciples to Jesus apart and said, why could not we cast them out? And Jesus said unto them, because of your unbelief. For verily I say unto you, if you have faith as a grain of mustard seed, you shall say to this mountain, remove hence to yonder place, and it shall remove. And nothing shall be impossible unto you. I said, nothing shall be impossible unto you. Watch verse 29. We will park here. Howbeit, this time, glory. This time goeth not out, but by prayer and fasting. Father, in the name of Jesus, send a word in this house tonight. Send an anointing upon me, your servant, Lord God, that will make preaching easy. Lord God, liberate every individual in this house. We cast out every demonic force by the blood of Jesus, and we declare that it is well in Jesus' name. Amen. Before you take your seat, I'm going to add a subtopic to your topic prayers that made the church bold. And I'll be using for my subject tonight. And I'm going to ask you to share it with your neighbor. When your faith and your mouth gets together, anything can happen.